Hey everyone. In today's video, I'm going to take you through how to use Zapier to connect up Jotform with HubSpot and to use Jotform as a trigger to then do another action in another platform. We're using HubSpot as an example in this video, but you could use any other software. You wanted to send details to a spreadsheet or to another CRM or into an email or whatever you like. So let's jump straight in and we go into Zapier. So I've logged into Zapier. I'm going to use the little AI option here to generate, to sort of set up the draft or the basic setup of the Zap or the automation, the workflow that I have in mind. And so we're going to say that when new form submission in Jotform, then add the contact to HubSpot. Cool. So let's try this Zap. And we're basically looking at what it says here. So when there's a new submission in Jotform, create the contact in HubSpot. This is a very simple example of how to set up a Zap with Jotform in Zapier. So we start by connecting up the Jotform account. And it looks like there's an error. So I'm going to try this another way. I'm going to go to manage all my connected accounts. And then I'm going to click add connection. We're going to find Jotform and see if we can add it like this. Cool. So I don't know why that other link didn't work, but this seems to have been an alternative. And so now we don't need HIPAA compliant and we don't need European data centers. So we can click yes to continue. We're going to log in here with our social mostly email account that we set up yesterday in the previous video. So you can check that one out. If you haven't seen that yet, a little introduction to Jotform. So I add in my details, log in. Cool. Now we've got Jotform here. So going back to our Zap, we can see now that this is connected up to Jotform account. So we can click continue. We find our form. And at the moment, we've just created one form, this contact us form. It looks like this. So we just select that. Here it is. And test the trigger. No submission found. So we need to do a submission. So I'm going to jump in here and publish. Copy the link in a new tab and let's do a submission here. Submit. So we test trigger again and we've got our submission that we just tested out. So then let's go down to continue and now we're going to go to the next step, create contact in HubSpot. So we actually want to create or update a contact. So let's do a quick search for contact. We want to select this one instead of the default create. Because there is a chance the contact may have already created an account, filled in the form or done something like that. They're already in the system. So we want to be able to update them if required. Then we choose our HubSpot account, click continue. Then we can select and add the email address that we've collected here. So we can see the email, just do a search, email, done. And then the other values we wanted to get would be first name. I'm just going to do a command F or control F to quickly jump down to the first name section because HubSpot just have so many properties there. And we're going to do a search for last name here. And then we also wanted to get phone number. I'm going to put it under the general phone number. And company name. Now, of course, HubSpot comes with forms, very good forms. And I would suggest if it's a simple contact us form like this, then I would use just the HubSpot forms if you are using HubSpot. But this is just a simple example in Zapier for how to connect up Jotform with another software, and HubSpot's one of my preferred CRMs, so I'm using that as an example here. But in general, I would say for a normal contact us form, you could use HubSpot, but maybe you've got some very specific questions or functionality that the HubSpot forms don't offer, and Jotform's really good for having all kinds of extra functionality for forms. So that's why you might be wanting to use Jotform, so we can test that step. And it looks like it's worked. And if we jump into HubSpot, we can see here that we've got this new contact submission here. This James Joshson from abrams.com. He's been added in from our Zap. So you can also see if you click on him and you look at your activities, we can see that it's come through this integration. We can in HubSpot even go into click on details to see where the property has been updated. And we can see that it's come through the Zapier integration as well. So then we have that all set up and we can click publish. And now this is ready to use. So basically all you have to do is create another submission and the details will go straight into HubSpot as well. So I'll do another video explaining a little bit more about Jotform and about connecting Jotform with HubSpot in other ways. And let me know if you've got any questions about Jotform, if you want to learn anything else specifically about the functionality of the platform. There's a lot of really cool things you can do with it. Please feel free to add it in the comments. And if this is useful for you, you want to see more videos like this, of course, subscribe and like the video if it's been helpful. And otherwise, I'll see you in the next video. Okay, thanks so much for watching. Cheers.